This is Calvin Kastein. It's the 18th day of October 2005, and we're at the Clinton Community College soccer field on an overcast and showery afternoon. It's approaching 3:30 p.m. game time in the Northern Independence Conference Championship Contest featuring the four-time defending champion Clinton Community College Cougars and their opponents, the Albany Pharmacy team. Crusaders, I can't remember what tech they're called. I should know. We've taped them enough times over the years. Different versions of Albany Pharmacy. We'll give a quick rundown on the roster of the home team Cougars. And we'll say hello right back to Sonia Dupree and Michelle Boyer, the only two who said hello to me as we walked across the field. Most of the rest we've taped since they were in just out of diapers, but they still don't know who I am, so we'll say hello to those two. Number two is Emily Colby. She was way back there on defense, so she couldn't very well say hello. Liz Everett is number three. Chelsea Bally is number four. Carrie Garand is five. Sonia Dupree is six. Jess Gadway is seven. Liz Fisk is 8, Jen Valige is 9, Lindsay Levesque is 10, Whitney Levatter 11, Becky Abbott, when she's on the field, wears number 12, she is the goalie. Jordan Hatch wears number 13, Jess Trombley wears number 14, Kristen Levine is number 15, Katie Matten is 16, Nicole Sample is 17, Renee Miner is 18, Dana Langlois is number 19, Michelle Boyer, 20, Carissa House, 21, Sierra Venn, 22, and Danielle Gallo is number 23. The coach, of course, is Donna Dixon. I assume she has an assistant, but I have no idea who that might be. The only players from Albany that we're aware of who are from the area are number 25 out there, Renee Minkler, and I believe number 12, Amber Cranack, is the Cranack that went to Seton Catholic. And Minkler's going to come over and hug one of her former classmates here from the Bobcat land. It's Albany Pharmacy and the Clinton Community College right here, right now on Hometown Cable. The referees today will be Jamie LaBarge on your right and Stevie Reagan on your left. Eileen Walker was very good about supporting hometown cable, but she is gone, and for the most part. So we show up once in a while, but obviously we can't give Clinton the coverage that we used to. Back in gold. So we can wrestle with this tripod. Tripod is fine for something like a board meeting where we're not going to get much camera movement, but and something like soccer was back and forth. It's a struggle. Nice stop by Abbott. We are at the 38-minute mark, 7 minutes into the game. 1-0. Clinton leading here in the early going. Albany, of course, a five-year school, a pharmacy school. A lot of our local graduates have gone there over the years and come back to work in the community. Playing against a two-year-old here at Clinton. White. Trying to put them on. There are two Cougars that came on that time. Dupree came back. Way by the pharmacist. Gadway fighting for it. Nice job by Jess Gadway to get to Guerin. Up to Dupree. To the 18. And there. This looks like maybe house on the far side. Is that possible? Yeah, looks like maybe house on the far side. Came in. Minor. Now Gadway sends it over to the far side. And it's kicked out of bounds by Levesque. Injured player for the pharmacy. And she is having great difficulty getting off the field. Cougar throw. Guerin, corral it, send it back this away. Call goes against Albany. Colby will put it in play. The fire still follows out. Dupree on it, and ball was still in. Play the whistle, play the whistle. To back.
Come on, Levine. Pick it up, Levine. Come on, Levine. Who's that? 1-5.
Gadway stops the ball. Scores 1-0. We're 11 minutes into the game. Championship game of the Northern Independence Conference. And Cranack, now that I recall here, I think is actually a Saranac name, not Seton Catholic. Cranack, Cranack's mother from, as I recall, from Rouse's Point originally. So that's number 12 on the visitors. Feel a little slippery, but considering all the rain we've had, it feels in pretty good shape. Colby sends it out of bounds. There's a shot. covered. Bell throws a Garen detail. Okay. under 10 now, 9:30 on the clock. Still 1-0, the goal coming at 1:28 into the game. Nice job clearing that out of there by Gallo. Up to Frey. Corner. The Sierra Van again. Hey. Some down by Gallo. All one will handle it.
Come on, White! Let's go!
Coming at the 1:28 mark, and I'm sure the players, along with their fans, are saying, "Hey, this is going to be easy," but it ain't easy yet. It's a one-goal game at the half here on Hometown Cable. Well, we knew it couldn't last forever. The rain is starting to come now. It was real nice down in the Woolsboro, Essex area today.
There you girls are.
But once we got back to Clinton County, we got close to the drizzle again, and it's been raining for most of the day. Second half is just underway. Abbott will pick it up, put it in play. Clinton Community College, one goal lead over Albany. First goal coming, the only goal coming at 45 minute halves. The batter is to Levine. And we found out from Amy Murphy that it's the Panthers, the Albany Pharmacy Panthers. And she has only one teammate out of all these girls, women, I'm supposed to say, I guess, on her summer league team, and that's Emily Colby. The rest play with somebody else if they play at all. But Cranach's mother, Shelley, told me to cheer for Albany, but that ain't gonna happen today. I'll cheer for Albany like I always cheer for the Red Sox to finish in second place. There's Levine. Sends it up the wing for Dupre, but Levesque gets there. There's a shot and stopped by the keeper, and she'll pick it up on a rebound. Valley does a nice little tumble. Colby will put it in play. Levine. Red throw. Colby sends it down. Again, we're doing this without a tripod. So a little shakier than normal. Red goal kick. Stopped by Bally. Sent back by the Panthers. Gadway lifts it. Panthers get there before Miner does. Well, sent down the field by Gallo up for Levesque. That's a red throw. Abbott. Just off the injured list. Had Valige filling in for her while she was out. And she helped, Valige helped to get the Cougars where they are today. A chance to get their fifth consecutive Northern Independence Conference Championship. It's in. That was Levesque, Everett scores, it's 2-0 Cougars. A little bit harder. Fortunately, there's no wind, so we're able to keep taping. Dupre on the wing. Levesque. Job by Nevada. Red throw. Referees today, Stevie Regan and Jamie LaBarge. I don't think either team's hollered at these guys yet, so they must be doing something right. Colby sends it up. Panthers with the ball. Gadway sends it up, looking for Bally. Now it's kicked back by the Panthers. Gadway with a short pass intended for Nevada. Ball's put in on net, and Abbott will handle it easily. There's a punt. Cougars will not get a shot off. Nevada throws it into Bally. Nevada sends it in. Colby. Ball stopped by Gadway. Ball sent up for Bally. The batter gets a foot on it. And Colby sends it through again. Colby will stop it. The Panthers will pick it up. Red throw. The batter. Gadway sends it up. See, Sample is in. Nicole Sample, 17. Garand is in. Wait, it's not Garand. Who is that? It's Ben. Garand is in, but that wasn't her that was chasing the ball. Ball gets by Bally. Gadway coming back for it. Colby says, I'll take that one, thank you. Nevada. Taken away. Ooh, a little strip on Nevada's part. I doubt if Joe Dumoulin taught her that. Must have learned that on her own. Red throw. Offside is called. Gallo will put it in play. Sent up to Bally. Bally goes up the wing for Venn. There's a kick. Light throw. There's a goal kick. No matter. Nice job by Nevada, passing intended for Miner. Gallo slaps it up, but out. 29 and a half remaining. Second half, Miner. Sent down deep by Levine. Sample given chase. Here come the Panthers. Gadway slows her down and Gallo sends it back down the field up for Sample. Garen gets a foot on it while Levine passing back to Miner. The rain starts to come down a little hard again. Gallo with a toss. Colby. Here's a shot, and Abbott makes the initial stop. Here's the rebound. That's way wide. 27 minutes remaining in the second half. Gallo will put it in play. Sample to Nevada. Back to Sample. Nevada will toss it in. Taken away from Sample. Red kick. Put it high in the air by Levine. Now Nevada. Sample goes to Nevada. Garen sends it up the field. Ball at midfield. I'm sure you can hear the rain on the umbrella. And you can probably see a few drops in the picture. Panthers will put it in play with about 25 remaining in the second half. Abbott will pick it up. Red charge. Gallo will take the kick. Gadway ball bounces off Miner and comes back for the Panthers. Winkler will not throw it in. Red throw. Abbott will carry it out. and a punt. Free kick for the Panthers. Picked up by Owen. Goal kick. Gallo will take the throw. Garen chasing it. Ball will stay in on the wet grass. House managed to knock it off. Albany. Miner steps in. Albany at the 18. There's Bali. Sends it up. She goes. Ball was going to Dupre, but referee Reagan decided to make the call. Sometimes you hear play on. You don't want to have a call taking the advantage away from the team with the ball, because then the call actually benefits the team that made the foul. Two nothing to score. Clinton Community College leading Albany Pharmacy. Northern Independence Conference Championship game. Cougars, the four-time defending champions, looking for a quintpeat. Not a repeat or a tripeat or a quadpeat, but a quintpeat. And a punt. Ball comes to Levesque. Up to Dupree. Everett will put it in play. Ball still alive. Sent out. Cougars almost had one there. We're approaching the 18-minute mark, our time remaining. Colby getting pushed off the ball, gets a foot in there. There's a shot into the Sumacs, and Gallo will put it in play. Garen kicks it out. Red throw. Two nothing to score. Garen tosses it in. Clinton Community College leading Albany Pharmacy. Cougars leading the Panthers here on Hometown Cable. Oh, wow. Abbott had the ball in her hands, but wasn't completely under control. And, Albany player kicking it. Apparently legal. But at 16 to go, we have a player down for Albany. Corner kick for the Cougars. Looks like everyone is set, waiting for the ref. One more player coming on. And now we're set. Jamie Labarge blows the whistle and where's the kick? Here it comes. The batter giving chase. Keeps it in play. Red throw. Colby trying to shield the ball. Colby puts it in play. Red throw. Get by House. But not Colby, and now Miner kicks it. A little over 14 remaining as Colby takes the goal kick. Headed by Miner. Kicked back by Albany. Now Gadway tries to send it up. It's sent up by Everett. Owen puts it in play. Albany with a restart at midfield. Offside. And Emily Colby will put it in play. And we do like to point out occasionally that Emma Lee is two names, not Emily, but Emma Lee. Apparently a push by Venn. There's a corner kick. Miner got a foot on it. Sent back in and through, and Abbott will pick it up. Miner, the batter, taken away by the Panthers. House over. Less than 10 remaining. Kicked in the air by Colby. Panthers have been putting the pressure on the Cougars the last several minutes. Here's Levine. Karen sends it forward offside. Duper is showing remarkable breaking ability there. Not easy putting the brakes on in a wet field. Panthers control the ball. Panthers quickly throw it in. Off red, it's a goal kick. Colby will put it in play. Rain is let up. October 18th, 2005, Northern Independence Conference Championship game. Four-time winners. Clinton Community College looking to make it five in a row. We have about 7.5 remaining in this 2-0 game. Gadway throws it in to the batter. Up to Dupree. Now Everett. Cougars keeping the pressure on. The ball's blown dead. Approaching the 6 minute mark. Dupree. It's a little bump for her efforts. Gadway sends it up to Miner. I'll send down. Headed by Dupree. Sunny D will take the throw to Levine. House trying to put it on the foot of a teammate. Levine sends it. Stopped by the keeper, Owen. Corner kick with under 4.5 remaining. There's the goal kick. Garen gets a foot on it. Dupree will throw it in to Levine. Goal kick with less than 3.5 remaining. Bally giving chase. The batter will throw it in. Garen couldn't get a foot on it now. Kicked up the wing to Dupree. Goal kick. Kick before Miner could get there. Kick it away from Gadway. Now it's a race at the 18. Abbott comes out of the box and kicks it. The batter sends it up the field. Infraction away from the ball. Panthers will put it in play. And Abbott makes the stop and a nice kick. Very nice kick. Takes her time. Time on the Cougars' side. They lead 2-0. Ball goes over Garen's head. 1 minute remaining. Dupree kicks it wide. Nevada gets there. Nevada carries it. Cougars uses up a lot of time in this corner kick. Here's Everett's kick. Levine with a high kick, no call. There's Garen. The Dupree. 1 second. There it is. The five-peats. Fifth year in a row, Clinton Community College is the Northern Independence Conference soccer champions. We'll stick around for their victory run and then we're going to be out of here.